Republican tidal wave of victories in the midterms going well beyond Washington, extending to a clean sweep of governor's races. Could the success on the state level shape the future for the party? Republican Governor Bill Haslam of Tennessee is the incoming chairman of the RGA. That's the Republican Governors Association. How are you, Gov? And good morning to you. 31 state houses across the country. Republican governors are on a roll. What will you do with that newfound power, sir?
I think the first message is for those who think the Republican Party has a limited message in a limited part of the country to look and say, wow, the Republicans won governorships in Massachusetts and Maryland and Illinois, the president's home state. For those who think we have an issue around women or demographics, you know, Governor Abbott won Texas by 10 points among female voters against a female candidate.
Why do you think that's happening?
Well, I honestly think this, when we have the right candidates and we have the right message that's about actually solving problems, I think we win elections. And I think that people looked out and saw the message coming from Republican candidates about how to actually address real budget issues in a world where people have given up hope that Washington has the courage to do that, about addressing factors to create more jobs and how to attract capital to our states and to our country. People saw and believe that Republican governors have done that and can continue to do that.
Now, do you think Republican governors have an advantage over Republican senators among that batch who's considering running for the White House in 2016?
Well, I do. Obviously, I'm a little biased. But I do think it helps to have come from a position where you actually have to solve the problem. You don't just get up and argue about it. It also, quite frankly, helps to be in a position where you have the ability to do that. In Washington, we have some Republican senators who are doing a great job. They're doing everything they can. But at the end of the day, they can't force the other side to come up to balance a budget, for instance. They can't force the other side to come up with a real issue for health care that helps cover more people and yet doesn't bust our budgets. As Republican governors, because ultimately we have to balance budgets, we're doing that and people are impressed with the results.
It was an interesting gathering there in Florida. You just broke from that group late on Friday. How do those men on that stage compare to Hillary Clinton?
Well, I think admirably so. Again, here's the thing I'd point back to the governors in Florida with the RGA. All of them have a track record of actually solving problems. And remember, I think the big thing the country's crying out for today is, can anybody actually do that? People have grown cynical that an answer can come, and definitely that answer can come out of Washington. And when they look at people who've actually helped their states move forward, whether it be job creation or education reform or definitely addressing long-term budget issues, I think there's encouragement from folks about what they see.
With regard to the budget issues, you think about Obamacare and the responsibility now, and also the immigration order. How does that change the way these men do their job?
Well, in terms of do their job as governors?
Yes.
Is that the question? Well, obviously, Obamacare has had a big impact on our state's budgets, already has. Got to remember, for most governors, Medicaid is the biggest portion of their budget. What we spend on health care in Tennessee is about one out of every $3 is spent on health care, either Medicaid or our own state employee health insurance. So the cost of health care drives everything else. And so squeezes out things like the money that goes to higher ed and makes tuition higher for middle class families all across the country. The point is, I think Republican governors would say, right, with Obamacare, we're covering more people, and that's a good thing. But what you didn't do is you didn't address the fundamental issue around the cost of health care, and it continues to squeeze out everything else in our state's budget, and it's the long-term issue. There's a lot of folks that feel like the federal government's quickly become just a large health insurance company that has an army and a navy attached to it. And that's not who we want to be as a country.
In the 15 seconds I have left, has Washington made it more difficult for you to do your job? Or is that pretty much come down to you and how well you manage at the executive level?
Well, I think that one of the beauties of being a governor is at the end of the day, you get to make a lot of those calls with your legislature about what happens. But Washington doesn't help with a lot of the policies they send our way. Here's the point I would make. The reason that states were set up as laboratories of democracy is the country's issues are so big that there's no way we can't handle them better in a more cost-effective and yet more compassionate way as governors than you can on the federal level. I guarantee you that's true.
Well, we've got to run. Thank you, sir. Bill Haslam from Tennessee with a new job, RGA. Thank you, sir. We'll speak again.
Thanks.
All right. Mark.